that he's bestowed upon us this morning. Listen, saints, I pray that you had a blessed weekend. I know it was a rough one this weekend. That storm came through just like they said it would. But how many of you know that doesn't stop us? We thank God for this venue, amen, that we're able to come together in this Zoom service and still be amongst the saints. And I thank God for this opportunity. I don't take it for granted, but it is an honor and a privilege, amen, to be able to come together, amen, even on this wise. Even though we're not together in one building, but we're together in spirit and we're together in unity on our Zoom service this morning. Amen. So at this time, I'm going to ask that Lady Matlock Michelle, that she would come and render us an opening prayer to the body of Christ this morning. God bless you.
Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we just thank you. We come giving you thanks, praise, honor, and glory. For this is the day that you have made. We choose to rejoice, and we are so glad in it. We thank you on today. We enter your gates with thanksgiving, your courts with praise, and we're thankful unto you. We come to bless your name, for you're worthy of all praise, all honor, and all of the glory. Father, on today, our heart desire is that it be all of you and absolutely none of us. Use us for your glory, Father, in this end time season. Anoint Pastor on today that the word will fall on good ground to each and every one of us on good ground and bring forth much fruit. Father, we thank you for the speaker on today. Use them for your glory. Let it be absolutely all of you and absolutely none of us. And we thank you in advance for the word falling on good ground and bringing forth much fruit to each account. We thank you, Father, most of all, even for our leaders throughout the country. We place each and every one of them, Father, before your throne, asking you to reveal yourself unto them as you do the same to us. For your grace is always sufficient. All of you and none of us. Deal with every leader, every auxiliary leader throughout the church, every leader in government, Father, all our leaders throughout this world. We thank you because we know when they're in your hands, they're in good hands. Make yourself known, Father, for your grace is sufficient. And we thank you for Jesus Christ giving us access to come boldly before your throne on today. And we give you praise, we give you honor, and all of the glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. We do, saints, we do pray for the government. We do pray for our elected officials. Amen. Amen. And we keep them before the throne of grace and mercy. Amen. That God will reveal himself to them. Amen. And if they would listen and hearken to the voice of the Lord, amen, this world, this society, this nation will be in a much better place. Amen. So it's our responsibility as believers to continue to keep them in prayer. Call their names out in prayer. Amen. That should be a part of our daily prayer, just to pray for leaders and government and authority in high places. Amen. That's our responsibility. So at this time, I'm going to ask that our deacon will come at this time, our Deacon Johnson, and our deaconess, you mourning with our morning scriptures, amen. And they will come at this time to read as God has laid on their hearts this morning. God bless you.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
I'll be reading the Old Testament, and it's going to come from Genesis chapter 17, verses 2 through 7. Genesis 17, verses 2 through 7, and it reads as such: "And I will make my covenant between me and thee, and will multiply thee exceedingly. And Abraham fell on his face, and God talked with him, saying, As for me, behold, my covenant is with thee, and thou shalt be a father of many nations. Neither shall thy name any more be called Abraham, but thy name shall be Abraham. For a father of many nations have I made thee, and I will make thee exceedingly fruitful, and I will make nations of thee, and kings shall come out of thee. And I will establish my covenant between me and thee and thy seed after thee in their generations for an everlasting covenant to be a God unto thee and to thy seed after thee." May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his holy word.
God bless you.
Amen.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
I'll be reading Matthew 16, verses 26 to 28 in the New Testament. And it reads thus, "For what is a man profit if he shall gain the whole world and lose his soul, or shall he give in exchange for his soul? For the Son of Man shall come in glory of his Father with his angels, and then he shall reward every man according to his worth. Verily I say unto you, there will be some standing there which shall not taste death till the Son of Man come in his kingdom." May God have a blessing to read over his word. May your peace deepen your heart and run out to tell somebody about the Christ we serve. Amen.
Amen. God bless you, my brother. God bless you, Deaconess Umorin. Amen. God bless you, Deacon Johnson. And thank you so much, Elder Michelle Matlock. Amen. For rendering to us the prayer and the scriptures for this morning. I'm going to take this opportunity to welcome everybody this morning to the household of faith. Amen. We thank you for tuning in. We thank you for, you know, not counting it robbery to just a log on this morning and to share in our service this morning. We thank you and we thank God for allowing you to tune in and be with us this morning. If you're a visitor, we want you to feel right at home. We want you to feel like you're a part of this body, amen, which you are. If you are a believer and you've been born again, we are of the same body. We are of the same spirit. We are of the same blood, amen. So we thank God for you that are visiting. Then we thank God for you that been partnering with us for the last several months. And some of us have been tuning in for the last year or so. We consider you family and a partner. We welcome you this morning as well. And then we thank God for our family members, NHBC, that are members and their names are written on the roll. We thank God for you, amen, for tuning in and being faithful and being committed to the word of God, because that's what it all boils down to, y'all. It's about the word of God. It's not about no big eyes, no little U's. It's not about no, pretty much no protocol or program. No, it's about the word of God, us being in love with hearing what thus saith the Lord, what God has to say to us on a daily basis, not just on a Wednesday night, not just on a Sunday morning, but every day of our lives, amen, God should be a part of our lives. His scripture, his word, meditate on his word. He said, meditate on his word day and night, amen. So we should constantly keep his word before us. We should constantly keep his concepts and precepts before our very eyes, like the scripture says. So I'm encouraged this morning. And I thank God for you. Like I said, I am the type of individual I kind of like try to discern and see even the smallest of things. And to me, for you to tune in, it may be small to you, but it's big to me. And I thank God for it. Amen. I thank God for it. So welcome this morning. Sit back, get ready for the word of God. Amen. We have a man of God this morning, our very own minister, Gerald. Truehart is going to bring us the word this morning. He's going to speak to our hearts. Normally we have, normally we have fifth Sunday, family and friends day, normally on a day like today, fifth Sunday, or we would have maybe women's day, or we haven't had our men's day yet, but eventually we'll get into that as well. But today is our fifth Sunday, amen. So we thank God for it. Family and friends on this day, amen. So we're going to look forward to hearing what God has to say through our very own New Horizon Baptist Church minister, Gerald. And we thank God for him, amen, speaking to his heart and him being prepared and being ready to do what thus saith the Lord. So I'm excited. I pray that you're excited, amen, because the word is the word, and I look forward to being fed this morning. How many of you look forward to being fed this morning? You got your spiritual food, spoons and knives and forks ready? Amen. See, I'm drinking my cup of tea, so I'm ready. I'm loosening up and I'm ready to receive. I'm ready to say amen. I'm ready to say hallelujah. And I'm ready to say glory be to God, to the word of God. Amen. So at this time, listen, before we have our announcements, we're going to have another song play. Amen. And let it minister to us. And then we're going to go forward with our announcements. Amen. So saints of God, be encouraged. Let the song minister to you, and we're going to move forward after that.
God, won't you take every
just want you.
Want you.
Yeah.
I just want you. I just want you. We just want you. We just want you. Yeah. We just want you. We just want you. So today.
Thank you, Father. How many of you just want Jesus this morning? Everything else is secondary. But just having Jesus in our lives, that's the most important thing in 2022. Thank you, Father.
Just want you.
Just want you.
Just want you. Just want you. We just want you. We just want you. Just want you. Just want you. Just want you. So take everything I say.
I just want you. I just want you. I just want you. Thank you, Lord.
We just want you.
Can we sing it one more time?
Everything, I don't want
Y'all thinking like y'all mean that thing. Take oh, every yeah. Day, I don't need it. If it don't please you.
Ah, yes. Thank you, Lord.
If it don't please you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Oh, my God, if it don't please God, y'all, I don't want it. How about you this morning? Take everything. Amen. See, this is so important, and I thank God for that song ministering to us. Listen, saints of God, it's all about him. Amen. Our life is all about him. Amen. If it is not pleasing to God, we don't need it. We don't want it. We want to do, say, think, act, respond in pleasing him. Amen. Our actions. Amen. Our thoughts. Amen. Our daily lifestyle, on our jobs. Amen. When we're driving down the street, somebody cut us off, we still want to respond in a holy and sanctified way. I know your flesh may get upset, may get mad at times, but listen, we put our flesh under our feet. Amen. And we respond the way God would want us to respond. How many of you want to please God this morning? Come on. How many of you want to please God this morning? Amen. He's a worthy, worthy God. Amen. And we thank God for him being our Father. I thank God for that song this morning. Amen. So at this time, saints of God, I want you to prepare for our announcements. Amen. And our announcements will be coming this morning from our very own Sister Sylvia Kinney. We're going to ask that she would come at this time and render to us our church announcements for this morning. God bless you as she comes.
Okay, good morning. Here are the church announcements. Let us remember our New Horizon members on the prayer list, as well as families experiencing bereavement, as we continue to celebrate the beginning of a new year. Remember, as we are one body in Christ, we pray for one another every day during the hours of 6 to 7 p.m. This is our intercessory prayer time. Also, show your concern for the brethren as the Spirit of God leads you to do so, with a phone call, a text message, even a card would be a great gesture. Pastor Matlock welcomes everyone, family and friends, visitors and partners to our Zoom service. Due to the severe snowstorm and concern for everyone's safety, our in-person church service was postponed this morning. We look forward to resuming our regular in-person church service on next Sunday at 10 a.m., the first Sunday of February 2022, and it will be Communion Sunday. Remember, you can give your tithes and offerings using the church website, www.nhbcofgroveville.org. Our thought for the week: thy word is a lamp to my feet, a light to my path always, to guide and to save me from sin, and show me the heavenly way. We cannot know the heart of God unless we have a heart for God. Thank you, and God bless everyone.
God bless you. God bless you, Sister Kinney. We thank God for those announcements. Job well done. Saints of God, please pay attention and bear those announcements in mind. Amen. And govern yourselves accordingly. Amen. We look forward to getting back into the house of God. Amen. On next Sunday, which is the first Sunday of February. Indeed, it will be Communion Sunday. Amen. Listen, saints, I want to just reiterate this. It's very important that we understand that we, as the body of believers, we pray for one another each and every day. Amen. And it's very important that we continue to do so. God has assigned us to continue to pray between the hour of 6 and 7 o'clock. And it's important that when we reach out to one another, amen, we can, some people may text, some people may email, some people may via phone call, whatever the case may be, but it's important that we be concerned about one another, amen, and look out for one another and check on one another. It's very important. So we thank God for you doing that, amen, reaching out, because that's a show of love and a show of concern for your brother and sister. So job well done, saints of God. Continue to just pray for one another as we do every day. As we do every day, this is what we do. This is our lifestyle. Amen. So there's really no special prayer. Not that I know of in the scripture, but prayer is, we just pray every day for everybody. We just look out for one another. Amen. There's no particular, if something's wrong with this one. So this is a special prayer for that. No, we pray every day, every day, every prayer is special. Amen. Every prayer is important. Every prayer means something to the body of Christ. So job well done, saints. Continue to just look out for one another. Continue to touch bases with one another and render whatever God lay on your heart. Like I said, whether it's a card, email, a text, or a phone call. Amen. That's important too. We appreciate you being concerned about each other. Amen. God bless you. We thank God for service thus far. We're going to again, listen to one more song, and then we're going to prepare ourselves. Prepare your hearts, prepare your minds, amen, for the word of God this morning, that God will send a word that would be, watch this, specifically tailor-made just for you, amen. I'm going to pull what I can pull out of it. You pull what you can pull out of it, amen. He may be preaching to all of us at the same time, but you get what God is saying to you, amen. Don't look at nobody else. Don't look at nobody else's. Judge nobody else. And you know, sometimes I'm going to say this too. Sometimes we hear a word and we get so excited, amen, amen, because we know that word is hitting somebody else. And we get so excited and we point fingers. The devil is alive. We ain't pointing no fingers. We ain't judging nobody. We're receiving that word into our, we're engrafting that word for ourselves. Amen. So everybody, get your apron, get your knives, get your forks, get your spoon. Let's get ready to dine on the word of God. Amen. So at this time, we just want to hear one more song, and then we're going to get right into the word of God. God bless you. Thank you again, Sister Kenny. Job well done. Come on, Fred Hammond. Bless us this morning. Yeah. Yeah, come on, y'all. Put your hands together right where you are. That's all right. Yeah.
Here we are.
Woo. Yes,
let's
sir.
One accord. Leave all your problems on the outside.
Leave them problems on the outside.
Soon,
yes.
The Holy Ghost fire.
Holy Ghost fire.
Open up your mouth. Woo. Lift the name of Jesus Christ. Say, yeah.
Are you ready for your blessing this morning, saints? Yeah. Come on, Mother Brown. I know you're ready. Yeah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, Rich. Hallelujah. Yeah. No one above you.
I know it might be tough to get your praise on.
Yeah.
Child of life, been touching your own cologne. You don't have a reason to praise, and let me give you one. I give you a brand new mercy with the rising of the sun. Destroy them when the prayer is ready.
Send the praise up, y'all, right where you are, in the midst of your circumstance, in the midst of whatever you're dealing with, whatever your issue is. Come on, send the praise up. Woo! Yeah. Hallelujah. Shout unto God. Yeah. Clap your hands. Stomp your feet.
Shake your head.
Come on, friend. Yeah. Come on, victory's in your praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Salvation. For your whole family. Deliverance.
Yes. Yes.
Because your praise is know this side. Know this side. Right now. He's here. He inhabits us.
He inhabits the praises of his people. Come on, you can praise him right there where you are. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on and give God praise. Come on, saints, put your hands together and give God praise. He is worthy of all the praise. Father, we thank you yet again. We thank you, God, for even your word. We pray, God, that you send your word right now, Father, through the man of God. Bless him right now from the crown of his head to the soles of his feet. Father, send him a word of inspiration, clarification, manifestation, declaration. Father, we pray, God, that you send him a revelation right through him right now in the name of Jesus. Use him for your glory, Father. It's not about us. It's all about you. So, God, we lift you up. We praise you. We magnify. We glorify. Do I have some praises in the house? Do I have some worshipers in the house? Come on, put your hands together for the man of God. God, we thank you, God, for none other than our very own minister, Gerald Truehart. Use him for your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. God,
amen. Amen. The God inhabits the praises of his people. I don't know about y'all, but I'm ready to praise him, lift up his name. Come on, y'all can open up, y'all. Y'all can turn your microphones on and praise God this morning. OMG. I see y'all don't want to. I tell you this right now. If you praise God, you speak to God.
Come on.
Whenever we praise God, OMG, whenever we praise God, we are speaking to God. I don't know about you, but I want to speak to God this morning. And I also want to hear a word that's going to edify me and lift me up, never to tear me down.
Thank you, Father.
When the word is preached over your life, that's when you begin to hear from God. But when you are speaking to God, you want to give God the praise. You want to lift God up in praise and worship. As Fred Hammond said, that God inhabits what? The praises of people.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. You know, I was in prayer and praise this morning when Pastor Al Malik had the other song on, and I began to think and begin to pray and begin to meditate on that word. And I recognized this morning, I talked to my mom this morning, and Mom Bevelyn Truehart, and I said, Mom, I'm preaching in this verse roll this morning, and I'd love to have you on, because normally we're in service over at New Horizon on a Main Street. And this was a great opportunity. And I sent Mom the link to today's virtual Zoom room here at New Horizon Baptist Church. And she's on the call. She's on the Zoom room this morning. And I want to recognize my mom, Bevelyn Truehart, this morning. And when I begin to prepare for today, even during the time of the praise and worship, the Spirit of God spoke to my heart. He said, you were birthed from your mother, and she poured into you all the good things that she poured into my spirit into my life so that I am an adult today by my mom's birth of my mom. But then God, the word of God spoke to my heart. He said, well, I birthed you through the spiritual realm. And the two things, your mother's, your natural birth and your spiritual birth come together for the work of God's glory. And so I just thank God. I praise God for Mom Truehart this morning. I praise God for my late father, Gerald, a Truehart senior. Bless his heart. And I just want to let you know that God inhabits the praises of his people. He is here to bless us this morning. He's here to edify us and lift us up this morning. And I just want to recognize God this morning that all words that come out of my mouth are from God, not from my mouth, not from me, but from God's spirit. I want to recognize Mother Brown this morning. God bless you, Mom Brown, Mother Brown this morning. I haven't seen you in live and in color, but it's good to see you this morning. I see you over there. I see you smiling. The joy of the Lord is your strength this morning. Deacon Johnson, God bless you. Deacon New Morin and Sister Walker, and of course, Lady Madlock and Pastor Elder Appleseed Madlock Jr., thank you so much for this opportunity to come before God's throne of grace and mercy and to deliver a word to edify and to uplift God's people. I see you folks. And I was so happy this morning when Sylvia Kennedy, she was actually, of course, did the announcements today. And I saw her smiling face, and she's always got a smile on her face. And what reminded me in God's word when I saw Sylvia Kenny's face this morning on Zoom, in the Zoom room, reminding me of the joy of the Lord is my strength. Glory to God this morning. And the joy of the Lord is our strength. I don't know about you, but actually I do know about you. I know that you believe in God's word. There you go, Sylvia. God bless you. I love your smile. I love you, Sylvia Kenny. God bless you. The joy of the Lord is your strength. It was happy to see your bright smile this morning. In the Zoom room this morning. Well, my beloved, you know, one of the things that Pastor's been preaching on is kingdom, that we are kingdom kids, that we have to walk as kingdom kids as we walk this earthly realm. And last week, he used Gideon as an example of how God will use the least of us in the kingdom to build up his kingdom and to usher in the spirit of the Lord upon all of us. You know, it's not about us, but it's about God who bestows that spirit of God and that spirit of righteousness in us, the justification of God in us and working on us, in us, and through us in God's word. And so I want to direct your attention today to a few scriptures. First of all, Matthew chapter 4 and verse 17 this morning. Matthew chapter 4. And verse 17, it says, from that time, Jesus began to preach and to say, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. From that time, Jesus began to preach and to say, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And then I want to go over to verse 19 this morning. And I want to read on this wise, the scripture reads on this wise out of the King James Version. It says, and he saith unto them, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. I want to preach from a share with you from the topic today, the kingdom of God, your identity in Christ. The kingdom of God, your identity in Christ. I want you to recognize, remember, even before that God said, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand, even before Christ talked about following him, he will make you fishers of men. And he's speaking to us today. He's not, I know he was speaking to those back in his time when he was in the earthly realm, speaking to the people of God and speaking to his disciples to follow him. But today he is speaking to us through his word. I don't know about you. Actually, I do. I want to hear a word from God that's going to edify me and lift me up. I want you to recognize, even before Jesus spoke these words, he was baptized in the Jordan River. And he was baptized, if you remember, by his cousin John the Baptist. And he came up out of that water after his baptism, and God spoke words. He said, this is my son in whom I am well pleased. I want you to recognize that God is speaking to your heart this morning through the spiritual realm. He's saying, this is my son. This is my daughter in whom I am well pleased. You are kingdom kids. You are birthed out of the baptism of Jesus Christ. You are birthed into the salvation of God and receive eternal life in him. You have repented of your sins, and many of you today have repented and spoke the words of your mouth and believed in your heart that Jesus is the Christ. He is the Son of the living God. And if you can believe on him, you shall have eternal life. God is speaking to your heart this morning. He's saying, this is my son, this is my daughter, in whom I am well pleased. But if you remember, even after his baptism was a preparation for his ministry. The baptism was a preparation for him to go into the wilderness after he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights. You remember the story in the book of Matthew, chapter 3 and chapter 4. When Jesus was fasting 40 days and 40 nights, and then he was tempted by the devil in the wilderness. I want you to recognize and glean from this message today that we are all tempted by the devil in one way or another throughout our life. And out our life, we have trials and we have tribulation. But God said, we may walk through that valley of the shadow of death, but fear no evil, for he is with us. His rod and his staff, they comfort us. So don't worry about the temptation. Don't worry about the trials. Don't worry about walking in the wilderness. You are baptized of God. You are baptized into the bosom of Christ. You are baptized into his salvation. You are baptized into new life. You are baptized to walk and follow Jesus. You are baptized to lead like Jesus. You have repented of your sins. You are walking as a kingdom kid. You are walking as an ambassador of God. You may find yourself in the wilderness experience in this earthly realm. You may find yourself in trials and tribulations in this earthly realm, but don't fret. Recognize that God is God and he can do all things. He can do all things because Christ strengthens us. I want you to recognize, and even in his wilderness experience, he used God's word over the devil. He used God's word over his adversary. He didn't speak his words. He spoke the words of God to crush the devil's head. And I want you to recognize even this morning that as a kingdom kid, as an ambassador of God, you have that same power in the words that you speak over your life and every situation that you might face in your life, on your job, in your nonprofit, in your community, in your church. You face those same situations and God's going to give you a word to overpower even the darkest darkness that you may find yourself walking through. Why? Because you are a light unto the world. You are that light in the nations. You are that light to the world. You are an ambassador. You are a kingdom kid. You are walking in God's earthly realm. You are walking in the kingdom. And then when he began his ministry after he was fasted 40 days and 40 nights, but even before he was baptized in the Jordan by his cousin, and he was tempted by the devil in the wilderness. And as he came out of that preparation, in preparation for his earthly ministry, Jesus began his ministry and he said, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. I want you to recognize this morning that the kingdom of God is at hand right now. We are in his kingdom right now in the earthly realm. I want you to recognize that you have power, authority, and influence in the words that you speak and what you believe in your heart. But there's one thing I want us to know, one question that I want us to ask ourselves today in this morning's worship and praise. I want us to answer the question, who am I? Who am I? This question prompts a healthy self-examination. Because we now have to define our identity and our life purpose. I want you to recognize that you were born with a God-given purpose and plan for your life. And you were created perfectly to fulfill that purpose that God has for you. Some of us, our purpose in God's kingdom is to be an usher. Some of us, our purpose in God's kingdom is to give announcements. Some of us, our purpose in God's kingdom is to preach God's word. Some of us, our purpose in God's kingdom is to be a trustee. Some of us, our purpose in God's word, amen, is to clean the church and be a good custodian of the church and be a good trustee over the congregation of the church and take care of things within the body of Christ. God has created perfectly to fulfill that purpose in his kingdom through you, his kingdom kids, his ambassador, the Most High God. You have to answer the question, who am I? Who am I in the kingdom? I want you to recognize that your core identity is rooted in the forgiving, saving, and redeeming work of Jesus the Christ. And the work that he did on your behalf when he hung on that rugged cross.
I can't get the thing on the
bottom. When he died in blood on that rugged cross, when he was buried in the tomb, and when they came and tried to find him, he had risen from the dead. Before he even ascended, he had risen from the dead, and he spoke to his disciples. But we ought to give God the praise and give God the glory for the risen Savior, for the sacrifice that he gave. But the question still is, who am I in Christ? Have you begun your self-examination? Have you begun to look into God's word to understand who you are? What is your identity? What is your life purpose in the kingdom? Well, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to share with you right now, your life purpose in the kingdom is found in God's word. God says you are God's handiwork. In Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10, it says, you are God's handiwork. Created in Christ Jesus to do what? To do good works. I want you to recognize that you are God's handiwork. I want you to recognize that that's your identity. I want you to recognize that that's your life purpose, that you are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus, created in this word of God to do good works. I want you to recognize that you are the righteousness of God through Christ. You are that righteousness, Sylvia Ken. That righteousness came over you this morning, and the joy of the Lord being your strength. You recognize that God is your strength, that God is your source, that God through Christ in his word will bring and edify you up and lift you up into a new purpose in your life. You may not already have walking in your purpose, but a word comes to edify and lift you up and give you the spiritual insight that you need to continue in that life purpose. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 21, it says, we learn that God made Jesus, who had no sin, to be sin for us, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. So it's not our own righteousness, Deke Johnson. It's not our own righteousness, First Lady Madlock. It's not our own righteousness, Deacon Yamora. It's not our own righteousness, Trustee Walker. It is God's righteousness through Christ that we walk in this earthly realm, as we walk by faith and not by sight, but as we walk in the work that Christ has given us. We're walking in the kingdom. What is your life purpose? How do you identify in God's earthly kingdom? I want us to recognize that God calls us, amen, God calls us his dearly love. In Colossians chapter 3, amen, Colossians chapter 3 and verse 12, it says, so as those who have been chosen of God, holy and beloved, put on a heart of compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. I want you to recognize that your identity in Christ is that you be filled with God's fruit, that you be filled with the fruit of God's spirit, that you are called the dearly beloved in God through Christ. I want you to recognize your identity in Christ, and you answering that question today, who am I, is found in God's word. And in Romans chapter 4, verse 12, it speaks on this wise that you are forgiven. It says, blessed are those whose lawless deeds have been forgiven You are forgiven because you spoke with your mouth and you believed in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord. That he died and he was raised from the dead just for you. And because you can believe, and because you do believe in your heart and speak with your mouth, that you are forgiven of God, that you are the forgiven, that you are blessed and highly favored. I want you to recognize in God's word that the question, who am I, is answered for you in God's word. If you just go to God's word and study God's word and pray in God's word and meditate on God's word, you'll find your life purpose right in God's word. You'll find out who you are in Christ. You'll find that you are an ambassador. You'll find that you are a kingdom kid. You'll find that you are chosen. You are chosen of God. In John chapter 15, in verse 19, God speaks on this wise. He says, if you are of the world would love its own. But because you are not of the world, but I have chosen you out of the world, because of this, the world hates you. Check this out. He has chosen you out of the world and out of the wickedness of this worldly system into the precious kingdom that he has prepared for you right now, even in the earthly realm. We are in the world, but not of the world, but we are of God's kingdom because we are kingdom kids. We are ambassadors of the Most High God. We are chosen. We are forgiven. We are the dearly beloved. We are God's handiwork. I want you to recognize who you are in Christ Jesus. I want you to go through this self-examination of who you are in Christ Jesus in his kingdom and identify yourself and your life purpose right in God's word. That's how I begin to recognize and glean and study in terms of who I am in God. I want to share with you who you are in the kingdom. I want you to recognize this morning that you are a royal priesthood. Y'all know that familiar scripture in 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 9. It says, but ye are a chosen generation. A royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praise of him who have called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. All we have to do is believe on him and whom he has sent. He sent the Lord Jesus in the word to heal all those who are oppressed of the devil. Let those words be spoken. Let those words be heard. Let it be all of him and none of us in Jesus' name. I want you to recognize when you answer that question, who am I? I want you to recognize today that you are a chosen generation. I want you to recognize today in his kingdom, you are a royal priesthood. I want you to recognize today in this kingdom, you are a holy nation, that you are a peculiar people. That you show forth the praises of him who have called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. That's why when it's time to praise and worship, you ought to stand on your feet, give God the praise, give God the glory. As you speak unto God, God will hear your voice. He will heal your land. He will bestow upon you the blessings that he has just for you. But you got to give God praise. You got to give God the glory. You got to speak to God. You got to speak his words over your life, over every situation in your life. You got to speak God's word. That's what Christ did in the wilderness. He was prepared. He fasted and prayed for 40 days and 40 nights before he was tempted of the devil. He was baptized by his cousin John the Baptist in Jordan River and received the Spirit of God. The sevenfold ministry, the seven spirits of God were on him, in him, and working through him even before he began in the wilderness journey, even before he began his ministry. You got to recognize who you are in Christ Jesus. I want you to know you are the apple of God's eye. We know familiar scripture in Psalm 17 and verse 8. We want to recognize the word of God. It says, keep me as the apple of the eye. Hide me under the shadow of thy wings. God wants you to hide under his shadow, under the shadow of the Almighty, from that fowler bird that comes to kill, steal, and to destroy your life, and to destroy your dreams, and to destroy your purpose, and to destroy your kingship, and to destroy your queenship, and to destroy everything that you have placed in God's hands. He wants to take out. But I want you to recognize who you are in Christ Jesus. I want you to recognize your identity in Christ. I want you to know that you are the light of the world. Matthew chapter 5 and verse 14, it speaks on this wise. It says, ye are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. In verse 15, neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven. I want to let you know, Mom, Mother Brown, when you walk in that church, you walk as the light of God. When you walk on your way in the highways and byways of life, in your life of 96 plus years, you are the light of the world. You are the light that's on a hill. It can't be hidden because your light so shines before men that they see your good works and they glorify your Father, which is in heaven. Because they can recognize that God is in the blessing business. God is leading and guiding you in all righteousness. God is leaving you and guiding you in longevity and health to your bones, even to your marrow and your bones. God is blessing you. You are light to the world. I want us to recognize in God's word that we are heirs with Jesus. It says that in Romans chapter 8, verse 17. I know I'm in a lot of scripture. I don't know any other way but to give God's word. It's not my words, but God's word that is drawn through me, in me, and working through me to share with the people of God what thus saith the Lord. In Romans chapter 8, verse 17, it speaks that we are heirs with Jesus. As we follow Jesus, as he called his four disciples, his initial four disciples, James, John, Peter. Who was the other one, Gwen? James, John, Peter, and Andrew. James, John, Peter, and Andrew. He's calling you to follow him, to be fishers of men. We are heirs with Jesus. It says, and if children, then heirs. If here in this word of children, then if kingdom kids, if ambassadors, if children of God in his kingdom with royal ambassadorship and priesthood. He called you, you are heirs of God. You are joint heirs with Christ. If so, be that we suffer with him, that we might may be also glorified together. God wants to glorify you. God wants to lift you up out of the muck and mire of the cave of this world system. He wants to lift you up out of the muck and mire of sin. He wants to lift you up out of the muck and mire of things going bad. He wants you to turn from your wicked ways and repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. He says, follow me, and I'll make you fishers of men. He wants you to know who am I in Christ. It required us to go through a self-examination to define our identity, to define, amen, our life purpose. I want you to recognize that you were born with a God-given purpose and plan for your life. And you were created perfectly to fulfill that purpose in God's earthly kingdom. I want you to recognize this morning that in the kingdom of God, you can identify who you are in Christ through his word. Don't go to anywhere else. Just go to God's word and identify who you are in God's word. And you can't go wrong, because the word goes forth. It does not go forth void, but it goes forth to accomplish everything that it is set out to accomplish. It is accomplishing that work in you, Deacon Johnson. It is accomplishing that work in you, Mom Truehart. It is accomplishing that work in you, Sylvia Kenny. It is accomplishing you that work, Brother Ricks. It is accomplishing that work in you, Deaconess Amora. It is accomplishing that work in you, Lady Madlock. It is accomplishing that work in you, Pastor. We're talking about God's kingdom. And our identity in God's kingdom, and we are to follow Jesus, the Christ, and none other. If someone else comes to you with a different word, you got to kick them out of your mind. For we, our warfare, our weapons are mighty through God. Our weapons are not carnal, but they are mighty what? Through God. To what? To the pulling down of strongholds. Don't allow the thoughts of the adversary. Don't allow the thoughts of this world system to take away your righteousness in God, to take away who you are in Christ Jesus. Continue to follow Jesus. He's asking you, follow me, follow me, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men in my kingdom, and you will have eternal life. And finally, this morning, as we go through God's word and recognize who we are in Christ Jesus, I want us to recognize that we are a friend of God. I know you are a friend of God. I'm a friend of God. In John 15, 14, God speaks through his word on this wise. He says, you are my friend if you do what I command you. So yes, we have to believe. Yes, we have to have faith. Yes, we have to walk with Christ. Yes, we have to lead like Jesus. Yes. We have to find our identity in God's word, but we also have to follow what Christ through God has commanded us to do in this earthly kingdom. We have to walk in that purpose. We have to walk in the purpose that God has given us to make disciples of all nations, baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and teaching all that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you even to the end of the age. I pray unto God that this word this morning has edified you, has lifted you up, has given you a word of edification and upliftment this morning. Sister and Brother Muse, I love you. It'd be good to see you guys. God bless you this morning. God bless all of our visitors this morning, all the people under the sound of my voice. I see you, Brother Jones. God bless you. I miss the keyboards. I miss the band. I miss you, Ricks, this morning. I miss you playing, Ricks. I miss you, Jones. I miss you, the drummer. What's the drummer's name, Deke? Tony. Thank you, Mom. Thank you, Mommy Gwen Truehart. I miss Tony on them drums. Well, I tell you, I can't wait to get back into the house of God on next Sunday. Glory to God. But until then, I want to leave you with this. I want you to recognize who you are in Christ Jesus. If nothing else, I want you to recognize that you are to follow Jesus. I want you to recognize that he's asking you. He is calling forth your name to follow him. He's asking you to repent of your sins. He's asking you to repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. He's asking you that you follow him and that you recognize who you are in Christ Jesus. You are a child of God. You are a kingdom kid. You are an ambassador of the Most High God, ambassador for Christ. So as you continue on today and in this next week, up to Bible study Sunday on Wednesday night, allow God to walk with you, and you walk with God, and you can be a world overcomer, a conqueror, because nothing can stop you if the word of God is in you, on you, working through you. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Lean not to your own understanding, but in all of your ways, acknowledge him. He will direct your paths this week and every week, every day of the week, he's going to direct you. But recognize who you are in Christ Jesus. God be the glory this morning. May God bless you. May God keep you. May God's light shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May God lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. In Yeshua's, in Jesus' master's name we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you this morning. God bless. Give God a hand praise with you this morning. God be the glory. Thank you so much, Elder Albert C. Madlock Jr., pastor of New Horizon Baptist Church, First Lady Michelle Madlock, Deaconess and Deacons, Deacon Johnson, Deacon Yamora. Amen. God bless all those under the sound of my voice. God bless you. Thank you so much for the opportunity to give God's word this morning, Pastor. I appreciate it.
Amen. 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 Man of God. What a word. What a word. Thank God for you, man of God. The kingdom of God, your identity in Christ. Amen. Saints of God, I pray you were blessed this morning because I truly was blessed this morning. And I am blessed by the word of God. I tell you, you got to, in New Horizons, you're going to have to start bringing out the forks, knives, and spoons. Amen. We're going to have to put the Similac away. Amen. We're going to have to put the milk bottles away because God is speaking a word to us. Amen. That's going to really build up your spiritual muscles. That's going to really let you know who you are in Christ. Amen. So we thank God for you, Minister Gerald. We thank God for you allowing God to speak to your heart, to God's people this morning. Listen, if there's anybody that don't know this Jesus that we're talking about this morning, I don't know if you receive them as your Lord and Savior, but this is your opportunity to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Amen. And that's what he did this morning. He was out there. Minister Gerald was throwing out the fishing line. He was throwing out the lifeline to those who don't know Jesus Christ to invite you into this beautiful kingdom of his dear son. So if you don't know him, I want you to raise your hands. If you do know him, it isn't going to hurt us to say this again and to always be at a spirit of repentance and always have a spirit of humility, amen, to submit ourselves to God and to his word. So would you do this with me? Would you repeat this prayer after me? Say, Heavenly Father, with outstretched hands, as a sign of surrender, as a sign of humility, amen. Lift up holy hands unto the Lord. And repeat this after me. Say, Heavenly Father, I come before you just as I am. I believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God. I believe that he died and you raised him from the dead just for me. I make that Jesus, the Christ, the Lord of my life. From this moment on, I yield my will to your will. I repent of my sins. Thank you, Father, for hearing my prayer. Thank you, Father, for forgiving me, saving me, and setting me free and delivering me. I am yours. You said in your word, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth and believe in thine heart that God has raised Jesus from the dead, I shall be saved. So today I receive that word. I believe that word. And I submit to you today my life. Speak to my heart. Lead me. Guide me into all truth. I'm saved. I'm yours. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Come on, saints of God. Let's praise God with them. Amen. The Bible says that heaven rejoices over one soul that comes into the kingdom of God. Amen. So if you weren't saved and you didn't give your heart to the Lord before that point, you are now a member of this kingdom of God. And I thank God for you. And the angels are rejoicing over that soul. Amen. Amen. So listen, saints of God, I'm going to ask that our trustees come at this time to render to us our announcements in reference to our giving this morning. Amen. So I'm going to ask that the trustees come and share with us our format to giving tithes and offerings this morning. God bless them as they come.
Good morning, New. Excuse me. Good morning, New Horizon.
Good morning.
Excellent word, Minister Truehart. It's giving time. Thank you for your generous contributions. We have five ways to give. You can mail your tithe offering to New Horizon Baptist Church, 200 Main Street, Groveville, New Jersey. The zip code 08620. You can do Cash App or Cash Tag. It's $ NHBC 200 GV. New Horizon Baptist Church of Groveville. You can use PayPal. The There's a QR code. You can access that from our website. You can do Zelle, and that's using the church's email address, which is nhbcofgroveville@gmail.com. And we also have Givelify. A free app is available. You have to download it, and you can tap it and select an amount and send it to the church. Remember, in your giving, please designate where you want your money to be spent in the church. You can do the building fund, which we need desperately right now. You can do tithe and offering, and you can do missions. And don't forget our pastor. He gives us a good word every Sunday, and you pay him. So don't forget him when you do your giving. Thank you, Pastor, for this opportunity. Each and every one of you have a safe and blessed week, and see you next week. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. God bless you. Saints of God, I just want to just make a slight correction on that. You really can't pay a man of God from what the word of God is worth, but we thank God for your generous giving and your love offering. Amen. That's what I know with Sister Lucy, man, you know, it's because of the love offerings, amen, you're able to give me something and to sow into my life. Amen. But the word of God, you can't even pay enough for the word of God. Amen. The word of God is so amazing. Amen. We can't even put a price on that. But listen, again, before we go, I just want to reiterate. In fact, this is what we're going to do. This is what we're going to do, because we don't want anybody to feel left out. We're going to have a word of prayer. Amen. I want everybody to touch and agree. And we're going to lift up our family members, amen, that's on the prayer list this morning, New Horizon prayer list. We're going to lift them up in prayer, no matter what the situation is, no matter what the circumstance is. And sometimes really, we really don't need to know what it is. All we need to do is just keep them in prayer. But we do that every day. So it's really nothing different than we've been normally doing. But today we're going to take this moment to say, listen, I want you to touch and agree with me, saints of God, that we intercede and call out the names of our loved ones and family members in prayer. So I'm going to call these names out. I'm calling out the names of Mother Jewel Brown, and thank Mother Jewel Brown for she's well and she's healthy. Amen. But we're going to call her name out. We're going to call out the names of Sister Odessa Downing, Brother the Holton family. We're going to call out the names of Sister Christine Jackson and her family. We're going to call out the Matlock family. We're going to call out the names of Brother and Sister Muse, amen. And we're going to call out the names of the Walker family, the Johnson family, the Ingram family, the Millard family, the Hicks family, the Jones family, the Wilcox family, the Jenkins family, the Chase family, the Holloway family. Father, we place these names at your throne of grace and mercy. And with the Gordon family, Father, the Henderson family, the Hicks family, the Moses family, Father, the Barksdale family, the Hightower family. We call out the names of the Vincent family, Father, the Hilliard family. All these names, Father, we place at your throne of grace and mercy, asking nothing of you, Father, other than you continue to reveal yourself to them. Father, we know if you continue to reveal yourself to them, your grace is sufficient. Now, we're not coming to you complaining. We never complain. We never murmur, Father, but we come to you and we take in those names and we place them at your throne of grace and mercy. And Father, we thank you, Father, for all that you've done and what you're going to do in their lives, no matter what the situation is, whether it's financial, whether it's sickness, whether it's physical, social, economical, whatever the case may be, Father, we send your word of healing right now to each family. We send your word of deliverance. We send your word of prosperity. We send your word of joy, peace, love, mercy, long-suffering, patience, Father. We send the fruit of the Spirit to each and every family right now, Father. And we say, cover them under your blood. Continue to just show favor and mercy in their behalf, Father. You know the situation. I don't need to know the situation. You know the situations, Father. So allow the Spirit of God, the Spirit of healing, to flow from heart to heart and from breast to breast. Father, we thank you for each and every individual. We thank you for each and every family member, one by one and name by name. We exalt your name, Father, you as Lord and you as God. Keep them in the hollow of your hand. Now, Father, we thank you for all that you've done. We thank you for what you're going to do. We intercede for them right now. We stand in the gap for them right now. And we declare and decree with your stripes, they are healed, set free, and delivered. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. Come on, saints of God, give God a praise. Come on, lift up those holy hands and give God a praise, because he is worthy of all the praise. Amen. So again, amen. If God so lead on your heart to reach out, amen, to touch somebody else's heart, just to show your concern. I don't see nothing wrong with that. Amen. To show your love and concern. Amen. To one another. God bless you. We thank God for you. Amen. We thank God for the announcements today. We thank God for the reading of this Holy Scripture. We thank God for the opening prayer. We thank God even for the welcome address. And we thank God most of all for the word of God. Amen. How many of you are glad that you received the word of God this morning? Amen. Again, thank you, Minister Gerald Truehart, for that word of God. Amen. I'm going to chew on that this week. The kingdom of God, your identity in Christ. Amen. I'm going to chew on that. And watch this. I don't know about you. And I'm going to say it. I don't know about the rest of y'all, but I'm going to try to know more about my identity in Christ this week, more than I learned last week. I'm going to try to get more knowledge of who I am and what I have the ability to do in this kingdom. Amen. So again, I thank God for each and every one of you, our visitors, partners, and friends, for joining us this morning at NHBC. Amen. So we look forward again to Wednesday night Bible study, 7 o'clock. God has been teaching us so awesomely in his word on Bible study Wednesday night. Please, sir, please, ma'am, tell somebody about Bible study. Tell somebody about the word that God has been giving us. Amen. And he's been giving us this word this for the last several weeks about trust. Amen. How we should trust in him, how we should depend on him. Amen. And lean not to our own understanding, but in all thy ways and everything that we do, everything that we try to do, hey, we trust in him. Amen. We lean not to our own understanding, but in all our ways, we acknowledge him, because he's leading and guiding and directing our path. Amen. So again, I thank you. I appreciate every one of you. And I pray that you were blessed. And I thank God for Sister Michelle Walker this morning. Amen. Amen. And I co-host everybody for allowing us to come up, amen, on Zoom, that we have this medium. And it was like a short notice, but, you know, we was trying to monitor the weather. Amen. And to make sure we had the opportunity to still have church. Amen. So we thank God for you being on point and ready to go and saying, listen, let's put it up. And we were able to have service this morning. So again, thank God for you. And we thank God for everybody under the sound of my voice. Mother Brown, we thank God for you being the church mother of the church, always praying and always keeping us up before the Lord. So we thank God for you. We don't take it lightly nor for granted, but we thank God for everybody that is in love with Jesus Christ. Amen. How many of you love with him this morning? Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. So listen, saints, we're going to have benediction. Got about 5 or 10 minutes. If anybody wanted to share a testimony or share a praise report or share just a word of encouragement to somebody else, you don't have, I tell you all the time, this is not about you giving me kudos or the speaker kudos after service. But if Deacon Yesu Morin had a word to share with Deacon Johnson that God laid on your heart, this is a good opportunity to do that. If Sister Kenny had a word she wanted to share with the whole body of Christ, this is a good opportunity to do that. Amen. We try to make room for just a testimony or praise report that will edify and continue to build us up. Amen. So at this time, we're going to have a benediction, and then we'll have a few minutes for anybody to share whatever God has laid on their heart this morning. So with outstretched hands, will you do this with me? With outstretched hands, well, I want you to repeat this after me. Say, more of thee and less of me, until there's all of thee and none of me. Now, may the grace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Ghost rest, rule, and abide with us henceforth, now and forever. And all of God's people said, amen. Amen. God bless you. God bless you, everybody that had a part to do in this service today.